When I'm working in film and television composing, I'll frequently get new edits of the picture with notes on timing changes. In this quick video, I'm going to show you the detailed process for moving an entire cue to a different location in the film. I'm working in MOTU's Digital Performer, and as you'll see, there's several steps you have to get right in order not to mess up the music. So let's take a look at my cue here. You can see that I am working in cue number 1M28 version 1.4. And with my counter rewound to the beginning, you can see that my SMPTE start time for this cue is 1:50:48:08. The goal of what I'm going to show you in this video is how to move this entire cue to a different location in picture. So the first thing I want to do is I want to duplicate my work because I want to make sure that I don't mess up my original. So in my chunks window, I'm going to duplicate this sequence. And even though by default it's called 1.4 copy, I need to make it 1.5. So let me rename this 1.4 copy and activate it. And now I'm in version 1.5, a perfect copy of 1.4, and I can always go back if I need to. We've been using the website qdb.com to keep track of this project. QDB is an excellent tool for tracking the progress over an entire film score. Now, when I go into QDB to read the editor's notes, I've been given the information that the start time for this cue has an offset. It's been moved later by 1 minute, 33 seconds, and 7 frames. The easiest way to deal with math like this is via a timecode calculator, so I've just googled for a simple SMPTE calculator. And here's one of my favorites. I'll leave a link to this down in the description below. First, I need to make sure the frame rate is set correctly. This film is shot at 23.976 frames per second. Now, I can input my original start time, which is 1:50:48:08, and now I'm going to add 1 minute, 33 seconds, and 7 frames. And the calculator now spits out my new start time of 1 hour, 52 minutes, 21 seconds, and 15 frames. So, back in Digital Performer, I'm going to go to my marker list and I'm going to unlock all of my markers. Why do I do that? If they stay locked, they would be locked to SMPTE time. And I don't want that. In this case, I want them locked to the music, to the bars and the beats. Therefore, they need to be unlocked. Now I'll go back to my chunks window, find version 1.5, right-click on it, and choose Set Chunk Start Time. Now I can change the start time of this cue to the calculation I got from the SMPTE calculator. 1 hour, 52 minutes, 21 seconds, and 15 frames. Once I hit return, this cue has now moved in time, and you can see that with me rewound to bar 1, the counter now reflects the correct new start time. My MIDI has all stayed intact, and the markers have stayed with the music. I'll now go back to the markers window and relock my markers, so now they lock to the new picture. The last step I need to do is open up the movie and update it to the new version of the movie. Once I've selected the new version of the movie, I'll right-click on it, and I'll import its movie audio, because there's a good chance it's going to differ from the previous version. Now at the bottom of the sequence, my new movie audio has been imported. I'll go ahead and move that to the top of my sequence where the previous version was. I'll disable the old version of the movie audio and route the new movie audio out through my buses so I can separate dialogue and temp music. And there it is. Now my cue is moved to its new location, everything's intact, the new version of picture is loaded up, and I'm ready to do further work in conforming on this cue.